This is our English worship service. We welcome you in Jesus' name. Father God, we thank you. We ask that you be enthroned above the praises and the worship of your people. Thank you for your presence right here in this room, right here in this place. And that all may see Christ and the beauty of Jesus Christ, and that we shall see no one but Jesus. And that we shall surrender our hearts to him, and we worship. For as we come before the presence of the Lord God, we come seated in Christ Jesus at the right hand of God in the third heavens, amongst all the angels and all the saints of God worshiping the Lord together. We thank you, Father God, for the Lamb that was slain. We thank you that as we stand on the glassy sea, oh yes, we see Christ Jesus by his blood that speaks the better thing for us. We are able to draw near to the Lord our God. And that as we are seated right now at the right hand of God, in Jesus' name, we decree and we declare the blessings of the Lord to overflow and the presence of the Lord God to overwhelm the children of God. These are the days of redemption and deliverance, says the Lord. These are the days where we shall rejoice because we are free to worship him in truth and in spirit. Let's turn to the scriptures. We're going to read from Psalm 89. The book of Psalm 89. Thank you, Jesus. As it comes, I'll just mention it. Yes. Hallelujah. Sukara parasiti ririkiaram baransanta repiteta katara. Thank you, Jesus. Oh Lord, we worship you. And as we stand before your presence, Father God, we acknowledge that you are mighty God. To you we give praise, to you we give worship, to you we give glory and honor. There is no one else like you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's a muscle of Ethan, the Ezrahite. I will sing of the Lord's great love forever with my mouth. I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you established your faithfulness in heaven itself. Thank you, Lord. You said, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David my servant. I will establish your line forever and make your throne firm through all generations. Selah. Selah means to pause and then to give worship to the Lord. And extol him and praise him and lift him up. Yes, and just let our praise and worship rise up to his throne. The heavens praise your wonders, O Lord, your faithfulness too, in the assembly of the holy ones. For who in the skies above can compare with the Lord? Who is like the Lord among the heavenly beings? In the council of the holy ones, God is greatly feared. He is more awesome than all who surround him. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Verse 8. O Lord God Almighty, who is like you? You are mighty, O Lord, and your faithfulness surrounds you. Let's unite our hearts together and to give him praise and worship. For he is worthy. For he is worthy. Thank you, Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus.
No other name.
be of power and of praise. His name is exalted far above the earth. His name is high above the heavens. His name is exalted far above the earth. Give glory and honor, praise unto his name. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of the Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus. Worthy of glory, worthy of honor, worthy of power and of praise. His name is exalted far above the earth. His name is high above the heavens. His name is exalted far above the earth. Give glory and honor, praise unto his name. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of the Lord. No other name but the name of Jesus. Worthy of glory, worthy of honor, worthy of power and of praise. Worthy of glory, worthy of honor, worthy of power and of praise. It's worthy of glory, worthy of honor, worthy of power and of praise. Hallelujah. Father God, we give you praise, we give you glory, we give you honor and worship. And let all the glories be given unto you. Hallelujah. Give the Lord the glories to his name. For his name is great, and there's no one like him. Oh, we praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. As we come before him, worship him. As I come, I behold the Lamb in the midst of the throne, with four living creatures and the elders. Behold the Lamb, looking as if it had been slain, with seven horns and seven eyes. The seven spirits of the living God. He took the scroll and opened the seven seals. Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lord. shouting, holy, holy, holy.
Holy, 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 worthy, worthy, worthy.
Holy. Hallelujah.
To make us a kingdom, priests unto our God. We shall reign on the earth. We shall reign on the earth.
Shout it and speak it.
We shall reign on the earth. 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 Holy. Thank you. has prevailed. The Lamb of God has prevailed.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
The Lord leads me on high. There is no thorn in God with me.
Declare.
The Lord leads me on high. There is no thorn in God with me. The Lord to alone make me ride on the heights of the land. You alone, mighty God, you alone, you alone leads me.
The Lord.
Leads me on high. There is no foreign God with me. The Lord, you alone, make me ride on the heights of the land. You alone, mighty God, you alone, you alone leads me. You fed me with the fruits of the fields. You nourish me with honey from the rock, and with oil from the fleeting grain, with cuts and milk from herds and flock, fat and lambs and goats, with choice rams of Bashan. Finest corn, oh, some wheat. I drink the pure of the vine.
Hallelujah.
The Lord leads me on high. There is no foreign God with me. your name. Great is your name. Jehovah Yahweh, great is your name. You are Lord of my shield, defender. My rock, salvation.
Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Father God, we praise you. Even now, Lord, we surrender our all to you. Even now, we declare that you alone are God. I can sense ears pop open in the name of Jesus. So I declare as we rule and reign in the third heaven, seated in Christ Jesus at the right hand of God, in Jesus' name, deaf ears opened and the mute speak plainly in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Oshantara kara para sote ridikia. Pranchiara nana hatadikia para sontaraka. Shukra para chichichikara para sontaraka. I see the Lord is shaking foundations. Foundations that are not of God. All lying foundations crumble at the sound of the voice of God in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Surrender your heart and your all to Him. For he is worthy, worthy, worthy. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I see a scripture. Thank you, Lord. The Lord says we are to surrender our all to him so that he may be all in all, the Lord our God. Matthew 22, verse 32. Matthew 22, 32. I am the God of Abraham, says the Lord. That's Jesus himself has been speaking. I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Is he not the God of the dead, but of the living? Hallelujah. Jesus is the God of the living. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 37 and 38. Jesus, the Word who came in the flesh, spoke this. He is the God of the living. Therefore, we decree and we declare, say, I am alive because I serve the living God. Amen? The living God declares, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob declares that I am the living, because he says he is the God of the living. Therefore, we are the living ones who live life and life more abundantly on the earth, and to live the eternal life that God has given to us. In the name of Jesus, amen. Jesus, the gate for the sheep, we pass through him. And we come into life and life abundant in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Verse 37 and 38. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. Love the Lord with all of your heart, soul, strength, and mind, and love your neighbors as yourself. For the obedience that the Lord has given to us, now we give the worship. We surrender the worship to his name. Romans 12. Romans 12, verses 1 and 2. Romans 12, verses 1 and 2. Thank you, Lord. Therefore, I urge you, says Paul, brothers or brethren, in view of God's mercy, offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Hallelujah. And he asked that the next scripture, that our mind be renewed. Do not conform as you worship him. Do not conform to the world, the pattern of the world. The world has its pattern, and it is old. It is filthy and dirty and sinful. It is full of deception and traps and lies. The pattern of this world, do not conform to it. Do not give your heart to it. Do not give your attention to it. Do not look at the glare it's offering to you. Even though it may be glittering, but the light from the second heaven, where the demonic spirits dwell, the lights are dim. But the light that comes from the third heaven, we are connected to the light from the third heaven. Jesus is the light of the world. As we are connected to him, bright, gloriously bright. Hallelujah. What comes up is also the scripture, James chapter 1, verse 17. Let's get that ready. Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. That means drop the thinkings that you have before, the familiar old thinkings. Begin to think God's thoughts and do what he says. You will walk in the new, in the name of Jesus. Amen? You will walk above and not under, in the name of Jesus. Then, as your mind is renewed, that's your thinking, you will be able to test and approve what God's will is. His good, pleasing, and perfect will. That means we need this process. As we look into the Word of God, and we comprehend the Word of God, and then we begin to take in the Word of God, and then you see things from His way of seeing. And you know things from His way of knowing, and then, all of a sudden, you will discover the things that you have been thinking about, the familiar old pattern, they are not good for you. They are the least for you, not just, you know, lesser. They are zeros for you. You find no value there. You find no place there, because the place of that familiar old sinful mindset is offered by the devil to stand next to him. Where did the devil stand? In the pit, bottomless pit. Because he rejected everything of God and the adornment of God. And he fell. That's at the rejection of everything that is of God's substance. Then he manifested to be one that falls, as Jesus said, like lightning, down to the bottomless pit, revealing himself to be nothing of God's beauty. That place is called the place of fallenness, it's called the place of pit. It's fallen short of the glory of God, and it's not standing at the place that God has for him. Jude 1:6 did say that those angels, the demons actually, that have been swept by the tail of this old dragon, the deceitful one, the accuser, the liar, the father of lies, he was the one that fell, and together with him, the one-third angels in heaven. Those angels did not keep their positions of authority, but abandoned their own home, because they did not also want the adornment of God. They fell, flashes of light coming down into the second heaven. But I want to present to you today, as we are preparing our heart to give an offering to the Lord God, that we ought to worship Him in truth and in spirit. Either you are for Him or you are not for Him. Either you are totally His, belonging to God, or that you may have some substance of the devil with you. No, you can't be in heaven. Because all of them, including the devil and all the fallen angels, they were all out of the third heaven. The light in the second heaven is dim. People who are connected, you know, the Chaldeans, the astrologers, those who are the magicians, those who are around the king of the earth, like Nebuchadnezzar. They are the ones who consult even up to the second heaven. But too bad they did not get up to the third heaven. So, what did they have in the second heaven cannot be able to save them, because King Nebuchadnezzar wanted their head off. If they cannot tell the dream that the king himself cannot remember, neither give the interpretation. Only the one connecting to the third heaven, the Spirit in Daniel, the Holy Spirit, connects Daniel to the third heavens and be able to know all things from God. Oh, hallelujah. And be able not only to interpret the dream for the king and give the interpretation, but also be crowned as the head, higher than all the satraps, higher than all the astrologers and the magicians and all the Chaldeans. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Those angels abandoned their own home. These, they have not kept their position. Therefore, Jesus Christ, God Himself, has kept them in darkness, bound with everlasting chains, for the judgment on the great day, in the name of Jesus. Therefore, do not conform to their way of thinking. They are influencing the sinful, fallen, the pattern of the world is patterned after them. Say, I drop these in Jesus' name today. I drop them in the name of Jesus now, because I have been appointed, I have been chosen as a son of God, to rise and to reign and to rule in the third heavens, seated in Christ Jesus, my King and my Lord and my Savior, my Mediator, the one who intercedes for me. Oh, hallelujah, my Redeemer. My Redeemer lives, therefore I live. He is the God of the living, and I am the living in the name of Jesus. And I shall live a glorious life that will testify to the glory of God on the earth, as it is written about me in heaven, in the Lamb's Book of Life, in the name of Jesus. Amen? Now, give God all that you have as we come to give Him an offering. You first give of yourself. Give of yourself. Surrender. Because He wants you to pattern after Him. So that in the image of Jesus, in the image of God, you can rise and rule and reign. So therefore, surrender and worship Him. Hallelujah. As you want to have your mind transformed and renewed, and did not want to pattern with the pattern of the world, that's worship. From that place at the altar now, then bring your offerings to Him, for He shall accept your offering. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hebrews chapter 7 comes. Hebrews chapter 7. And we're going to turn to that page and prepare ourselves for offering. This Melchizedek, that is the high priest of the order of Jesus Christ. Hebrews chapter 7, verse 1. This Melchizedek was king of Salem, priest of God Most High. He met Abraham returning from the defeat of the kings and blessed him. It is the greater that blessed the lesser. Abraham gave him a tenth of everything first. His name means king of righteousness. Then also king of Salem means king of peace. Without father or mother, without genealogy, without beginning of days or end of life, like the Son of God, he remains a priest forever. Think about this. Just think how great he was. Even the patriarch Abraham gave him a tithe of the plunder. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. This man is greater. Therefore, he receives the tithe from Abraham. Therefore, we who are in Jesus Christ, saved and born again. Let's turn to the page for the offering. We are going to render back to our Heavenly Father, back to God, all the tithes due His name, because they are holy and they are His. And we also can worship Him by giving Him free will offerings. And He shall multiply back unto us, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men pour back into your laps, His word said. With the measure you have measured to Him, so shall it be measured back to you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Now I release the blessing of the Lord upon you. For every tither who worships by surrendering your heart at the altar, to say, I do not want to pattern myself after the pattern of the world. At this place of worship, then give back unto God His holy tithes. In Jesus' name, I declare that He releases unto you the blessings with open heaven, open windows. Hallelujah. Pour back unto you so much that you don't even have room enough to contain. We receive it in the name of Jesus, that you rebuke the devourer for our sake, and that the fruits of our planting, the fruits of our vine, shall not cast before their time. In Jesus' name, we'll come into full maturity and we reap a harvest of plenty. And we shall be called, our land shall be called, the land blessed by the Lord, the Lord's delight. Hallelujah. And in Jesus' name, I release also a blessing unto those who are sowing unto the Lord God by giving with your free will It's a free will offering. Now may the Lord multiply back to you 30, 60, and 100-fold accordingly in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Now let's sing a song. It's called All to Jesus, I Surrender. It's in there. All to Jesus, I Surrender. As we prepare our hearts, thank you, Lord. As we give and as we worship Father God, we pray to give because it is an act of worship.
All to Jesus, I surrender. All to Him, I freely give. Love and trust Him in His presence daily live. I surrender all. I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all.
Worship Jesus.
All to Jesus I surrender, humbly at His feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now.
Sing the stanza 2 again.
All to Jesus I surrender, humbly at His feet I bow.
Declare you want to forsake the world.
Holy pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now.
One more time.
Oh, to Jesus I surrender, humbly at Your feet I bow.
Declare you wanna love Him and follow Him.
Worldly pleasures I choose to forsake, take me, Jesus, take me now.
I surrender all.
I surrender all. I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. I surrender all.
Surrender your heart to Him.
Surrender
your will and your emotion to Him.
All to Thee, my blessed. risen Savior, I surrender all.
Stanza one. Number one.
Oh, to Jesus I surrender. Oh, to Him I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him in His presence daily live.
Turn the word Him to you. To you, O Lord Jesus.
Oh, to Jesus I surrender. All to you I freely give.
Sing it as you mean it.
I will ever love and trust you in your presence daily live.
Surrender your all to Him now.
I surrender all. I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. I surrender all.
Yes, Jesus.
I surrender all.
Receive our worship to your name.
All to you, my blessed Savior.
I say,
I surrender all.
If you are willing to surrender to Him, yield. Yield to Him. And say, Lord, I obey you. Lord, I come to obey you. I come to take heed of your words. Very living word from your mouth. And begin to declare to Him. Stanza two.
Oh, to Jesus I surrender, humbly at His feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now.
Tell Him you want to forsake the world.
Worldly pleasures are forsaken. Take me, Jesus, take me now.
One more time, tell Him.
Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now.
Now surrender and worship Him.
I surrender all. I surrender all to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all.
One more time. Sing it from your heart. Sing it from your spirit and from your soul. Seal it unto the Lord, the worship of our heart. Father God, let it be the sealing of this agreement that we are the living, because you are the God of the living, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You live inside of us, and we become alive. And now we surrender our all to worship you. Yes. We agree with Paul that it is no longer I who live, but Christ. The fullness of truth and everything truth and the whole person of Jesus and his whole attitude, everything of him live inside of me. I nail my old self on the cross as a worship unto you, Father God, as an act of surrender. Yes, be pleased to be enthroned above our worship in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for the blood of Jesus covering over us. Thank you for the anointing of the Holy Spirit upon us. Renew us afresh. I speak life unto any places of death right now in the name of Jesus. Be alive for the Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, be awakened. For the glory of the Lord, in the name of Jesus. Live life and life eternal on earth as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. Manifesting the dominion and the glory of Jesus right now. Yes, for we are seated at the right hand of God inside of Christ Jesus, reigning and ruling in power and in dominion. Thank you, Lord. In the image of God, in Jesus' name, we give you praise. We give you glory and worship and honor, dominion, faith. Oh, yes, Lord. We give you wisdom. We give you splendid and majesty. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. All things beneficial, all things good belong to you, for you are God who loves us. Father, we thank you. Heavenly Father, our Abba Father, we worship you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, the Lord is saying to us. He says, the Lord has appointed us, his people. We have been appointed by the Lord God as male and female in his image, so that we may be priests, king, and also prophet. So many people know about the priesthood of believers, and a lot of people are pursuing there. A lot of people are pursuing the prophetic words of God. We stand and we can prophesy. We prophesy a thing and it shall be. Hallelujah. We prophesy a thing and it shall be. Why? Because we have the image of Jesus Christ within us. But we need to rule and reign as king. Because we have been appointed the governors. Here's a scripture, the description. We have been appointed as governors of God's divine dominion on the earth as it is in heaven. Hallelujah. It is to rule and reign in the image of God in the whole world, representing God's righteous dominion, including bringing the kingdom culture with us, so that we may influence all the living. For we are blessed. We have enjoyment in the eternal realm. For God has said, He has promised. He says, I will put enmity between the snake and the woman, and between the devil's seed and the seed who is Messiah. We are of the seed of Messiah. Because we are born again through the shed blood of Jesus Christ, and therefore we reign and rule. For Jesus Christ will bruise the head of the devil, and indeed Jesus Christ has come, the Son of Man has come and has destroyed the works of the devil. The snake can, by occasion of the people's neglect or being deceived, unnoticed, unaware, fallen into the place of temptation, thereby the lifestyle of believers can be attacked by the devil. But if we remain in the presence of the Lord, remaining in the person of Jesus Christ, and in this great intercessor, our mediator, who mediates on our behalf in the courtroom of God, and declare that this one, when we repent and turn from our sins, we shall be restored back to fullness again. We shall be restored to wholeness. We shall be restored and begin to reign and rule again like Jesus. Hallelujah. For Jesus, our Lord, His life is within us. Thank you, Lord. And we are in Him. Hallelujah. Now, I want to explain the word dominion. Because today we want to look at, I haven't shown you this. Look at how we can have dominion in the image of God at the place of worship. At the place of worship, which is living at the altar place of worship, we can have dominion in the image of God. Dominion is different from ruling over. Have dominion means the king comes to stay within the realm of his creation and to make sure everything is all right. The fish swim as fish. The beasts of the field, they run. You know, the lions, they go the lion's way. And the birds, they should have their flight and their niche in that level. Now, having dominion means the king himself will want to come and visit, will want to come and be with his creation. That's dominion, in order to extend a pattern, which is not the pattern of the world, in order to extend his rulership so that all creation can see how it is being ruled and reigned. It is to love, it is to protect, it is to provide and make sure the spiritual godly order of God's spiritual things are there, so that all living things exist and become good. That's why Jesus has his dominion by coming in the flesh. If you are just lording over, you don't come down. That's the pattern of the world. You lord over, you rule over, and you are saying, I'm up here. You're down there. That's not having dominion. Dominion stems out of God's righteousness and loving kindness, whereby His throne is established forever. Whatever word God says is, His word is the foundation of our existence. His word is the foundation for life, where we exist and have our being fully free, because God is love. He loves and wants the best for us. That's why we can live free and have such a king to govern over us. But amazing thing is, God comes in the form of Jesus Christ, the second person of the Godhead, where everything that has shape and form can become. He himself comes and live amongst his creation. Oh, that's mighty. Fully having truth and grace extending to us, thereby we can live and live within his dominion forever and forever and forever. See, when Jesus comes, we originally, as the governors appointed by God, male and female, in the image of God, we have been appointed the first heaven, which is the sky, the earth, and the sea. But after Jesus defeated the devil, because the devil comes and drags people down to where he has fallen to, his place is never a good place. It's lower even than the earth. It's called the underworld. It's called the underneath, the most underneath, the pit, the Sheol, the pit. After Jesus' death and resurrection, oh, this is powerful. Then we who believe in him, we who put faith in him, we anchor our faith upon Jesus Christ, he who made an entrance into the Holy of Holies, the curtain split into half. Jesus went in there into the Holy of Holies, the presence of God. And God smelled the fragrance of the Son who is without sin. And because of that, the Lord spoke. Because he is of God's own kind. He is the same of God's kind. The Godhead, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. That's why they can fellowship. We now are being taken inside of Jesus Christ, our high priest, into the Holy of Holies. Therefore, we have been given rulership to rule over everything underneath the third heavens, in and through Jesus Christ. Amen? So the fallen angels, we have dominion over them. We have dominion over any fallen angel. Of course, we have dominion over Satan. This is a true statement. Because John 16, verse 11, the prince of the world has already been judged by Jesus' death and resurrection. Hallelujah. Oh, mighty, mighty, mighty. Now, we represent God to all the creation as the ones who have prayed to receive Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior. We are carrying the true image of God as the governor, the rightful governors on the earth to rule and reign. Let's look at the other one. Here it says, Deuteronomy chapter 5, from verses 22 to 27. When we are having this dominion, understand this, like Jesus came in the flesh. He comes to show us how to walk in that dominion. We walk on the earth, not thinking to ourselves and fending for ourselves. No, we walk on the earth, listening to the word spoken by the Lord up in the third heavens. We are seated together with Father God at the right hand of God. That means the position of power with resurrection power to do everything because we sit there and reign with him, right? Now understand this. With that image that is totally now bringing us into the realm without sin, we can speak anything from the third heavens down and things be and things become exactly as God wants them to be. That's why we are kings. Because we sit enthroned with Jesus Christ and we begin to speak and declare, this should be this, that should be that, as exactly according to what I see my Father does. Oh, John chapter 5, verses 19 to 20. John 5, let's prepare that for after this verse. John 5, 19 to 20. Now we need to be hearing what God is saying and seeing what God is doing. with Jesus Christ, because he is the second person who comes in the flesh, we can see him. Therefore, concerning the word, you know, the word that you read from the scripture, you need to be in contact with the word and touch the life within the word. Holy Spirit will bring life, so that when you touch the word, it's not the written, just writings word, but it is the living word, Jesus himself. As you touch him, you can see what he's doing, as he sees what the Father does. Then you do. Hallelujah. Now, with the Holy Spirit, John 16 tells us, you don't have to turn, John 16, from verses 13 to 15, for the Spirit of God, you don't need to see it in order to do it. You need to hear the voice, the still small voice of the Holy Spirit speaking to you, then you do it. Because the Holy Spirit hears the conversation between Father God and the Lord Jesus Christ, and he heard, and then he tells us everything about who Jesus is and reminds us about Jesus' teaching. If you want to see things, how the procedures are, and how to do things, see the word manifested. See how Jesus does the thing. As he sees Father God is doing it. And then if you're not sure, you say, Father God, as you have shown Jesus, your son, I'm your son, the same, show me. Father God loves the son, therefore he shows the son. In the same way, God loves us equal to Jesus. The same, because we are all sons. Father God wants to show us. Now with the Holy Spirit, you hear his instruction now. You don't base on what your physical eyes see. You hear his instruction, you follow his instruction, things be. Oh, thank you, Jesus. See, I receive in Jesus' name. I receive the equipping in Jesus' name, amen? In year 2022, we need to live in the spirit realm and be in the physical realm in the name of Jesus. Oh, Deuteronomy 5, 22 to 27. These words the Lord spoke. At that point, it was on around Mount Sinai when Moses brought the people, the Israelites, to that place, already out of the place of sin, represented by Egypt. They've already passed the Red Sea. That means already baptized and belonging to God. Baptized, repented, unto receiving Jesus and follow him. Repent, Matthew 3, 8. Repent so that you may bear fruit in accordance to or in line with the repentance. Yes. So going through the Red Sea, speaking about you go through water baptism. You want to forsake all sin, Egypt. You want to forsake all demons, pursuing, harassing demons, and break all the covenants in Jesus' name. Now, if you have not break any covenant, which either your forefather had set for you, or your parents may have dedicated you, or you may have had in the previous worship of other religion, any kind of contract, any kind of agreement, any kind of vow, any kind of covenant. You may have purchased something in order to have a ceremony done for you. That's called initiation in Jesus' name. Right now, if you want to follow Jesus Christ, you say, Father God, I come before you. I now want to part with all these things. I want only to come into the blood covenant you have for me inside of Jesus Christ. I come into the blood covenant of Jesus Christ, and I want Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Not only Savior, I give Jesus the right of my life. I do not own my life. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives inside of me beginning now. I give you, Lord Jesus, the ownership of my entire life, and I crown you as the Lord of my life. So you are not only my Savior, but you are the Lord of my life. So I come into this blood covenant you have between you and Father God. You put me inside there, Lord Jesus, and you cover over me with your blood. So in Jesus' name, we take authority now. We break and cut off every covenant agreement you may have had with any worship of other gods. The blood is sufficient. The blood is sufficient. The blood of Jesus is sufficient. Say in Jesus' name, I am now free. I am now free to worship God in truth and in spirit, for the blood has cleansed me. I belong to Jesus. In Jesus' name, I can call Father God, Abba Father. I choose to live inside of the covenant of the blood of Jesus. I will never come out of it. Me and my family, you will save in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Yes. These words of the Lord spoke to all of you, to all your assembly at the mountain from the midst of the fire, of the cloud and of the thick gloom with a great voice. And he added no more. He wrote them on two tablets of stone and gave them to me. And when you heard the voice from the midst of the darkness, while the mountain was burning with fire, you came near to me, all the heads of your tribes and your elders. You said, oh, behold, the Lord our God has shown us his glory and his greatness, and we have heard his voice from the midst of the fire. And we have seen today that God speaks with men, yet he lives. Moses is a sign and a wonder because he saw the burning bush, remember? Why is the burning bush a sign and a wonder? Because the very bush that can be burned by fire is not destroyed. We who believe in the Lord Jesus, we are hidden in him. And we can dwell with consuming fire, God himself, with piercing holiness, and we are not destroyed. We are the sign and the wonder of today. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Here it says, the people of God had said, the Lord our God has shown us his glory. The presence has come. The presence of God is with us. And the presence of God is consuming fire, full of holiness, piercing holiness, and with greatness. The demons will cringe and they would leave. Hallelujah. We heard his voice. The presence, in the presence, when the presence comes, you need to listen and you need to wait until you hear the voice of Father God speaking to you. That's the ultimate. That's the ultimate. Why? Because line number three, he added no more. The voice of Father God is the ultimate, where he added no more. Thank you, Jesus. And we need to hear him speak to us today. And we can still be alive to hear his voice or by the shed blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is how we have dominion inside of Jesus Christ, the Word of God who came in the flesh, who shows us how to carry the image of God and live a life that really exercise dominion over everything. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Now there's a scripture, John 5:19-20. Thank you, Holy Spirit. He's reminding we must read that scripture. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Jesus gave them this answer. I tell you the truth. The Son can do nothing by himself. That's why when God sends us as his representatives on the earth to have dominion, we cannot do it without the Father. We cannot do it without being connected to the Heavenly Father, who is the source of our everything, including our existence. The Son, Jesus Christ, and we in Him, after His death and resurrection, after we place our faith in Him, as Jesus cannot do anything by Himself, He can do only what He sees the Father God is doing. His Father means the relationship between God and Jesus in the flesh. That means they have communication. Relationship is to have communication. Because whatever the Father does, the Son does also. Oh, thank you, Lord. For the Father loves the Son and shows Him all He does. So in the same way, for whatever that you need to do, beginning now and today, God has given each one of us calling, assignments, gifts, provisions, blessings, protections, and everything, and even put us under the protection of the name of His Son, Jesus Christ, whose name is above all names. At the mentioning of the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. When Jesus rose from the dead, what is the name that God has given to Jesus? Such that God has exalted the word Jesus and the name Lord of Lords, King of Kings. Jesus' title is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Yes, the Father loves the Son and shows Him all He does. In the same way, God protects us all within that title, that name of Jesus. Any person in position, any spirit in position that wants to lord over you, you just declare, I am under the name of Jesus Christ. His title, Lord of Lords. Are you a Lord trying to lord over me? No. I'm under a lordship. The Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. I'm under the kingship of Jesus, as the ambassador of the gospel of Jesus Christ sent from heaven. That's who we are. That's our identity. Hallelujah. And we sit with Christ ruling and reigning at the right hand of God. Yes, to your amazement, He will show Him even greater things than this, that is to raise the people from the dead. And we shall raise people from the dead. To bring people to accept Jesus as Lord and Savior is to raise the dead, whereby the spirit of the person can be connected to God, eternal life, and live. That's the greatest miracle. So in the physical realm, we can also raise people from the dead. If we do not give up in declaring life, anybody can be raised to life. So would you want to travail? There was a lady, since Holy Spirit brings testimony, you know? He says, talk about this. Now there was a lady, some scholars, teachers, you know, professors and of the seminary, went to Africa. She's one of the students. They're trying to pass her, you know? She is like studying and studying and studying, and then she failed each time. Cannot pass her course. So the teachers gathered together after a few times, 3-4 times. They were saying she has repeated this again and again and again and again, and she failed the course again. What should we do? Well, they were thinking, but we cannot do what she can do. The professors, the teachers, you know, all those who are the experts. We cannot do what she does. What did she do? Somebody will come to where she stays and bring a dead baby. She would, take it over, like nothing happened. And she's rocking and she's praying. After 2 hours, give you a live baby. Sometimes she would rock for 4 hours, sometimes 6 hours. But no matter what, she will give you a live baby, resurrected. So the teachers and the professors and all those who are designing the course, they are saying, we cannot do what she can do. We have to pass her in some way, you know, so that she can graduate. She graduated before the course happens. Hallelujah. Yes. Oh, let's give the Lord a clap offering. Yes. Now, that's ruling and reigning in life and with life. You know how important you are? This is what Holy Spirit tells me to tell you. The very most important thing about you is that you can bring life and speak life and declare life where there is death, any place where the principles of death are working. You go there and you declare life. If you don't give up, life, even from the dead, people will be raised. There was a pastor. He was told that a girl was dead. He has been known to be able to raise people from the dead, maybe after 7 or 8 hours, because he doesn't give up. This time, after 8 hours of travailing, the other pastor who was with him said, Pastor, this is past 8 hours. Maybe we should just give the child back to the mother and, you know, let her be buried. Thank God that the pastor put such a persistent faith, travailing faith that would not quit. He said no. He would have nothing, but he wanted the girl to live. And he just stand before the Lord God and travail and travail past 12 hours. He still would not give up. And he said, God, no matter what, I will not give up. And I shall not give up. At the 13th hour, the devil has to let go. The child became alive. We already have the eternal life. It's up to if we want to the ultimate to speak life. Once that life is manifested, it's easier the second time. It's easier the third time. And it's easier and easier and easier until we can speak like Jesus. Wake up. And the person can be resurrected from the coffin. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Hey, I preach myself happy. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, let's go back to the scripture. Yes. Jesus said to the believers, you know, to his disciples, to have dominion. Now we know James and John came with the mother. One son sit on the right, one son sit on the left, is the request. Now, of course, Jesus said, no, this is appointed by the Lord God himself. You know, nobody can determine that. So the rest of the disciples, they knew what had happened, right? Jesus called the disciples to himself. Now, this is powerful. He calls us to himself so that we may see him and how he does things. Understand? That we may see how he does things. You know, the rulers of the Gentiles lorded over them. Those who are great exercise authority over them. That's not the kingdom of Jesus type of being a leader. A leader never lords over. Never, rule over people. We have dominion over the devil, the circumstances. We have dominion over every evil, bad, dark things. You know, when God's Holy Spirit came, let's look at that scripture in Genesis chapter 1. Yes. Oh, yes. That very same condition, we lord over that. And we speak life. That's how we have dominion. Hallelujah. Like Jesus comes in the flesh, We do that in the bodily form. Oh, thank you, Jesus. The earth was formless and empty. Why? Because there's no God substance, no spiritual structure for anything that is of good, perfect, pleasing will of God to stand in there. No spiritual substance of God in the structure of righteousness to stand and be. Void, 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 formless, empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep. That's why God, scripture comes again. Psalm 42, 7 to 8. The book of Psalm 42, verses 7 and 8. Wait 1 minute. Just get that ready. Because the deep calls to the deep. You know? I just say wait 1 minute. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Where are we? Okay, it's okay. Now, the lording over. Never lord over. When we are on Genesis chapter 1, you know? Aloha. Genesis chapter 1. Yes. Right. Genesis, find the scripture, chapter 1. Those things that are called the formless, full of lies and emptiness. Even till today, old tricks, you know? The devil will give you a box, a shell, decorated nicely, inside empty. Have you ever seen the wrappings? Oh, one time somebody gave me durian cake. Yes. It was big package. I said, oh, nice. Open it. Oh, only three. Open the small wrap. There was a small little square thing, you know, dinky as ever. And I took it out. Genesis chapter 1. And I saw that thing, you know. So I took out all the wrappings and put the three durian cake. If you put the small little thing there, the wrapping is five times the size, you know, but it's not the thing. Oh, hallelujah. Now, there, the earth, formless. You need to know what it is. Today, if your life is having something that is formless, you want something good from the Lord, and it does not produce what is the pleasurable will of God that is good and perfect and pleasurable from the Lord, you know you fall into the devil's trap. You have accepted a frame, empty box of chaos. When God's word comes, you know, when God's word comes, there is the presence of God. So we need to, in our worship, we need to draw close to God until the presence of the Lord God is known. That's why don't talk too much. Let him talk. He is talkative. Father God is talkative. He wants to do all the talking. He meant for you to do all the listening and the receiving. That's why scribes came, you know, taking down notes. Precise. Past tense, present tense, future tense. Okay, all the tenses there. And then you go and speak it. Voila, it happens on the earth as it is in heaven. So what God wants to do is that we may have dominion in his image by having his presence as we worship, and you hear what he says. Anything that is formless and empty and full of darkness in anybody's life will need somebody who can do this to them. Who have dominion and speak the dominion of God into their lives to destroy anything that is of sin, of death, the principles of death, the presence of death, including sickness and disease, anything chaos, anything empty Without the beauty of Jesus is empty. Without the perfect will of God is empty. Because only His good and perfect will can have substance. That's why, you know, the winnowing, the grain full of substance, drop, weighty. The glory of God is called weighty, with substance. When the Holy Spirit wind blows, you know, those without substance fly off. This is it. From Genesis chapter 1, verse 2. We need to wake up and say, hiya, I'm dealing with this all along. Say, the Lord, wake me up, wake me up, wake me up, wake me up in Jesus' name. Amen. Ha! Amen. Okay. The Spirit of God hovering over it. Presence. Don't look at the chaos and say, this is how bad. This is how bad. You mentioned 3 months. How bad, how bad, how bad. You couldn't come out of it. You understand what I'm saying? Oh, the Holy Spirit is going this way. Because the Holy Spirit presence can come. As long as the church is around, as long as there are people who receive Jesus as Lord and Savior, and know that we are seated at the right hand of God, reigning, we are the governors of the earth, we need to be doing the work of speaking, delivering what we hear from Him in the throne room, and release it down to the first heaven, into the lives of the people. People who keeps talking about their past. You see what I'm saying? Empty talks. If they don't yield to the Spirit of God, they will talk, mountain, 40 years, never come out of it. They themselves reduced to nothing. Their children's destiny reduced to nothing. So who wants to rise and reign today? Let it be made known that you make a choice for life and not for death. For year 2022, you need to make that decision for yourself. Decide whom you may serve. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God hovering over the waters, multitudes of people, is called waters. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. And what's next? And God said, let there be light. God's voice came from His presence when the Spirit of God is moving. That's the third heaven. Don't speak from under the first heaven, you know, amongst the waters, the multitudes of people. Not speaking from the first heaven. If you want change, never speak from the first heaven. Speak from the third heaven down to the first heaven, knowing who you are. Governors of the earth that has a mandate to hear from the voice of God what He speaks, speak it and bring the changes. We are responsible to speak it and to be the witnesses to see it happen right in front of your face. That's called a witness. You know? Hallelujah. God's voice said, whatever He said settles it. Because from Mount Sinai, He adds nothing to it. His voice and His voice alone. Let there be light. That's Jesus Christ. The light of the world. Let my Son, my beloved Son, Jesus Christ, comes in the flesh and dwell in you. Dwell in your midst. Come to the earth. There was light. That's why the prophetic words say, the people living along the coast of Galilee have seen a great light. That's the light of the world, Jesus Christ, with His life coming and coming through in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen? Oh, this is how we rule and reign. This is how. Be at the place where God, with God, in the presence. Worship Him. Surrendering. Why? Because you want to make sure no flesh exists. You want to make sure no old self Don't talk about me. Nothing of me exists in that realm. Only Christ, the truth. Only Christ, who can take shape and form, exists. Oh, yes, thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's look at the next in the PowerPoint. We now are different from the Old Testament. We now see Jesus Christ and we can live. Hallelujah. And Jesus said, do not lord over the people. We lord over the demons. We lord over circumstances. We lord over everything that is dark and chaotic. Anything from the Genesis chapter 1 verse 2. Anything without the spiritual structure of God to create good, we lord over them and we command their destruction in the name of Jesus. Amen? Why? Because the Son of Man has come, he has destroyed the work of the devil. We too, Romans 8 tells us, we also manifest it as sons of God. And we take authority in Jesus' name. We command and we summon the creation to line up now with the purpose of salvation. Leave the hands of the wicked. And we command in Jesus' name, the wicked people and the wicked structures and the wicked spirits that cage people, in Jesus' name, all their platforms, all their lying platforms, all their evil things, in Jesus' name, break apart. Amen? The word of God, like big hammer. Oh, I see a round, big thing, like full of fire, coming and destroy the altars of evil. In Jesus' name, you shall see beginning today what's going to happen to the world. Even if one son of God speak. Who? Oh. Jesus is powerful. He wants the whole world be full of sons of God. Now that's having dominion. The kingdom of the devil is already finished. They are under the feet of the believers of Jesus Christ. So don't talk about them too much. If you think that they want to harass you or come near you, in your thought, you say, what? They are already gone. Because James 4, verse 7 tells us, you resisted, you come back to God. James 4, verses 7 and 8. You draw back to God and you leave the worldly thing. You know, friendship with the world is animosity with God. But you resist the devil, he will flee from you. You resist him, he will flee from you. Submit to God. If you want to have dominion, you must, for the rest of your life, never leave the covering of authority. The one who stays under authority has authority. The one who leaves the place of authority does not have authority, like the devil. Thank you, Jesus. Ooh, let's worship the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to the Lamb of God.
Okay.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we praise you, we worship you. We thank you, Lord. You are good and awesome. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There is a scripture, Proverbs 27, verse 21. You can sit or you can stand in the presence of the Lord. Feel free. Because those who exalt himself, you lift up yourself, you are debasing yourself. Because pride comes before the fall. Humility comes before exaltation. Because as you humble and wait on the Lord, the key for you today, wait. Wait and don't talk. Wait and stay in the presence of the Lord. How long should I wait? Only God knows. But you need to make a decision to wait in his presence. That's worship. In the surrendering that says, I want to exalt him and I want to love him with all of my heart, soul, strength, and mind. And I want to love my neighbors as myself. Surrender before him and wait until he speaks, until he convicts. The scripture that comes is Psalm 42, verses 7 and 8. See, Holy Spirit is he has his own way of bringing the message. He says, let your deep calls to the deep of the Lord from the cloud of his voice. His voice came from his presence, from deep inside of him, comes forth through the word Jesus Christ. His very living spirit calling forth to you from within the deep of him. See how much he loves us. Calling to our deep. Oh, in the roar of your waterfalls. You know when Jesus, that's John 7, 37 to 38. Don't turn there. Just in case somebody needs the reference for them to go back home and check, you know. We don't need it here. Yeah. So what I'm saying is, when Jesus on the greatest feast, that is the Feast of Tabernacle, and on the greatest day, which is finishing the seventh day, and after it is finished on the eighth, that's the new beginning. Is supposed to be speaking about the millennial rule of Jesus Christ. pointing to the future. That comes, we celebrate the fact that the seven last year of the Jews will come. We celebrate the fact that we shall be raptured first, and the seven last year of the Jews will come, and Christ is going to travail, and he's going to prevail against the Antichrist. Even his chosen people will go past the Antichrist. That's powerful. And be able to join us as we, the bride of the Lamb, are coming back together with Jesus Christ from heaven after that 7 years of the supper of the Lamb. And Jesus will clean up things and set up his 1,000 years of millennial rule. That Feast of Tabernacle is the rejoicing before it comes, like Abraham sees the day of Jesus Christ and believe. Father of faith, ooh, hallelujah, sees the day of Jesus' death and resurrection and believe that God can raise the dead. We too believe. We too see beyond all that. Past time, we have seen past the timeline of physical existence to come into the spiritual existence of God. We are forever dwelling in eternity with God, and we see that that 1,000 years will come. Jesus stood on the eighth day. That's the eighth day. The new beginning of everything. From inside of Jesus, he says, those who believe concerning the Holy Spirit, out from his belly will flow rivers, plural. Every areas of our lives are well watered and nurtured. No more death, no more disease, no more barrenness, no more famine, no more debt, lack and poverty, no more shame, no more anything that is of the fallen order of anything. We don't even have the sinful fallen nature, because the baptism of Holy Spirit and with fire, the baptism of fire destroys that old self completely in the name of Jesus. Amen. That's why we need the baptism of not just the Holy Spirit, but with fire, to dwell with consuming fire, so that we don't even think a thought that is lesser than his glory. Who? Out of your waterfalls, the flowing in of the rivers of life into the every areas of our life, the voice of God calls out from the very deep of that fountain, of that source of life, and pours out water spouts, you know? You know, have you ever seen the spring, you know? When the water comes, it shoots up. Worship the Lord to the place where the water is stirring and rising up. It's gonna bring your spirit. You're sitting on that spout, open up. You are sitting there, rising to the heart of God and join with Father God in his heart. You lean over, you hear what he says, you see what he sees, you be what he calls you to be. You're one substance with him. Who? Thank you, Lord Jesus. It takes the whole life to comprehend, but it's okay. Sometimes, you know, well, the Lord is good anyway. Okay, let's go here. Deep, the deep of God calls to the deep inside of you, so that as you worship, the river of life in every areas of your life rise up. And you are brought by the deep of the Lord God, by the Holy Spirit, into his presence. All your waves and your breakers have swept over me, overcame totally with the presence of the Lord God. You will hear no other sound but the voice of God. No, that, what do you call it? The deer, you know? Let's go back up here a little bit. Since we're at this. The deer pants, panting for the streams, plural, of water. Like, you know? So we want every stream of God to flow in every areas of our lives, in the area of your relationship. Imagine, you have all the perfect relationships. That would be crowning with lots of crowns and glory. You know? Reign in life, even in your relationship. And over your finances. Oh, many crowns over there that the Lord wants to give to His children. Begin to stay at that place inside of Jesus Christ, at the position of power with God. Hear His water spout calling you. The deep of God speak through His presence to come to you. Now you receive His voice. You know? Anything of chaotic structure collapse. They can't sustain the glory of God in your life. In the area of finance, they collapse. Oh, easy. In the area of relationship, they collapse too. Any areas of your life. Now, the word becomes manifested in you. Begin to speak. Things be exactly as God speak, and things become exactly the same. How many of you want that? How many of you know that we are this? We have been called to this. Yes. See? Right. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. As the deer pants, you need to be thirsty. God, give me that spiritual hunger that I will continue to be so hungry and increase the hunger. I will not give up till I get it. Hallelujah. Don't give up until you have all of God in the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, don't talk about, oh, I want His blessings. I want His blessings. I want His blessings. I want God. Hallelujah. In the fullness of everything He is. Keep me inside of you and never let me go. Hallelujah. Never let me come out of you. Oh. Now, when the deer was walking, it's okay. Fanning for herself and fanning for himself, you know. Male and female. Oh, I like. But the hunters, the pursuers are there. Bang! Now, that's a few hundred miles away. And the deer was already scared. Scared by the word of the devil, you know. Run. Don't see you. Don't see the wind of you running away. See the dust. No. The Lord has given us the spirit of dominion. Amen. They should be afraid of you. You are not supposed to be afraid of them. They are a little mouse just right there behind the big speaker. Have you seen that picture? And the mouse goes, that's all. And then you see a big lion. Oh, it's actually a mouse. Never succumb to the tricks of the spirit of fear. You just say, fear. You think in your mind, you are going to bind it with the lasting chains of Jesus, cage it in the places of darkness, let it wait for the day of great judgment. You just think that. Just look at it. Look at the spirit of fear and think that. I tell you, the spirit of fear will run. It will not even come near your door because you're too freaky for the spirit of fear. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. In the name of Jesus, yes. Hallelujah. The same with the spirit of sickness and disease. The same. Say this with me. The same. The same. That's their end. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Now, when the deer is running, being afraid, sweat comes. Hound dogs scent for the deer. Can smell the scent. No matter how you run. But there is one place of safety. You better be near the stream of the Lord. You better be near the place of the word and the overflowing of the word and the spring of the word of life, better be near it. Quickly go into the water. Walk the trail of the water. Because your scent will be diminished by the sounds and the smell of the water. The hounds will not find you when the deer is in the water. Stay, stay. My soul is where? The part that always likes to sin. Now, as sinners before we accept Jesus Christ, this soul is reigning, you know, governing, being alive. I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to rule. I want to reign. I want to have this. Cars and houses and businesses. Oh, yeah, you name it all. I will. You know? Now, the spirit is dead, not connected to God. It was supposed to be our spirit connected to the spirit of God, and then the soul, and then the body. That's a spiritual structure of God's order of life for mankind, for health and for healing. A lot of people goes with the emotion. That's the second level now. Without any regard for the spirit being, neither the spirit of God. Today, say today, I am returning to the spiritual order of God. My spirit is connected to the Holy Spirit who comes and lives inside of me. In Jesus' name, amen. Yes, my soul lives and obey the truth. And then my body recovers. You need to bless your soul. Because you haven't received blessings. Or you didn't allow yourself to be blessed too much. Or you didn't bless yourself. You say, I bless myself. I like myself the way God created me to be. I bless myself. I am the best God has created. Because I'm the only kind. Unique. But I'm of the order of the Son of God type. In Jesus' name, amen. Then, you are the most beautiful, most wonderful, the best of the type of the Son of God. The way that you are created for. The other person, they are the best. And they are the most beautiful of the intention of God for them. As God created them. Each one favorite children of God in the name of Jesus. Amen. So bless your soul. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, let's go back to the PowerPoint. Yes. This song comes. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to mention this. Proverbs 27, verse 21. Crucible for silver, furnace for gold. If people give you any praise, oh, Pastor Grace, you're so good. I tell you, you have just tested me. How? By your words of calling me good. Jesus said, who is good? Some rich young ruler came and said, good teacher. Jesus said, who is good now except God? We are all children redeemed by the grace of God, all under the great grace of God. If anybody would give you any accolades and praise, and, oh, you're so good at this. Wow, you're the best. You are this. Don't listen too long. Because it could be very irritating to your spirit. Then that's a good sign. You say, praise the Lord. I give God all the glories and all the accolades, all the worship. If he doesn't give me an ounce of his breath, I will not exist. I would be dead. Thank you, Jesus. So for anyone who wants to call you good, make sure you give glories to God. Hallelujah. You know why? Because people have fallen from the position, from Adam and Eve, we've fallen from the place of goodness and glory. Now that God has delivered us, He is returning us back to the place of glory. Therefore, it is our responsibility to harvest all the glories that should belong to God in creation and give it back to Him. The creations are put into their position of being under oppression, groaning and moaning because of the sons of Adam. We need to go and rescue them and get them back so that as they are returning to the Lord, returning to the place of glory, we give all the glories to the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Let's sing the song. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Yes, it's in there. Yes, the Lord has reminded. Declare you want to serve the Lord God alone. No other God, no other image, but the image of God and the image of Jesus Christ in us. Amen. Give God glories.
As for me, we will serve you, Lord, lifting holy hands in worship. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel.
Again. Yes, as for me.
As for me and my house, we will serve you, Lord, lifting holy hands in worship. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. We will worship the God of Israel. For you are holy, holy. There is no one else like you. You are holy, there is no one else like you.
Declare it.
You are holy, holy. There is no one else like you. Thank you.
time.
Kadosh, Kadosh atah, in kamoha Adonai. Kadosh, Kadosh atah, choose this day whom you may serve. 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 As for me and my house, we will serve you, Lord. We will serve you, God.
As for me, stanza one.
As for me and my house, we will serve you, Lord, lifting holy hands in worship. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. As for me and my house, we will serve you, Lord, lifting holy hands in worship. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. We will worship the God of Israel. You are holy, holy. There is no one else like you. You are holy, holy. There's no one else like you.
Declare it.
You are holy, holy. There is no one else like you. You are holy, holy. There is no one else like you.
Kadosh.
Kadosh. Kadosh atah. In kamoha Adonai. Kadosh. Kadosh atah. In kamoha Adonai. Kadosh, Kadosh atah. In kamoha Adonai. Kadosh, Kadosh atah. In kamoha Adonai. Choose this day whom you may serve. Choose this day whom you may serve.
One more time.
Choose this day whom you may serve. Choose this day whom you may serve.
us. As for me,
and my house, we will serve you, Lord, lifting holy hands in worship. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. We will worship the God of Israel. We will not bow down to the gods of men. We will worship the God of Israel. We will worship the God of
Thank you, Father God. We come to have a covenant with the Lord our God, and that we may worship no other but the living God Himself. Thank you, Jesus. Let's worship Him. You have heard His words. You are holy. You are holy soul, yes. Thank you, Jesus. Make your covenant with Him. Thank you, Jesus. You are none like you. You are holy, holy. Glory to you alone. You are holy. You are holy. to your throne.
I found where I belong.
I see the restoration of sonship. You have been called to be in the courts of God, to sit and to rule and to reign. Yes, we are so close to the throne of God. In Jesus Christ, we are seated in Him with Father God. You are holy, holy, Lord, there is none like You. You are holy, holy, glory to You alone. I'll sing Your praises forever, deeper in love with You. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong. I'll sing Your praises forever, deeper in love with You. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong. You are holy. Thank You, Lord, that we can behold the beauty of Your holiness.
You are holy, holy, Lord, there is none like You. You are holy, holy, glory to You alone. I'll sing Your praises forever, deeper in love with You. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong. I'll sing Your praises forever, deeper in love with You. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong.
One more time, I'll sing Your praises.
I'll sing Your praises forever, deeper in love with You. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong.
Come back to the place You belong.
Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where I belong. Here in Your courts where I'm close to Your throne, I found where
below. Father God, we come to worship you. We pray to worship you in truth and in spirit. We surrender our all to you. As the deep calls to the deep, may your water spout bring us up. And that we may see you and hear your voice in your presence, O Lord. Bring us into the cloud of your presence.
Here in your courts where I'm close to your throne.
Well, in Christ Jesus with you, Father God,
I found where I belong.
Speak it.
Here in your courts, I am close to your throne. Father, I found where I should belong. Where I'm close to your throne, I am where I belong.
I am at where I belong.
I am at where I belong. Here in your courts, when I'm close to your throne, I am at where I belong. Here in your courts, where I'm close to your throne, I am where I am below.
Father, we thank you. We give you all the praise, glory, worship, honor, fame, power, splendid, dominion. You are worthy of all of it. In Jesus' name, we bless the children of God to come into the presence of the Lord God and to be at the place where you have found yourself. We all belong in Jesus Christ at the right hand of God, seated. We are where the throne is. For the Lord, our Father, calls from his deep to our deep. We are his, and he is mine. Thank you, Lord. Now receive the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face toward you and grant you his peace. Shalom. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We have a few announcements. The first one is every Thursday night at 7 p.m. we have a bilingual service, which is called, Father God says, call it the hour of victory, because it is to bring people to live inside of that established reality by Jesus Christ. That glory realm is here and manifesting and expanding. When you come in to that realm of Jesus has already won all the victory, you shall be saved, healed, delivered, blessed, and set free in the mighty name of Jesus. For as many as come, you shall be free, says the Lord in Jesus' name. Amen. Salvation has been established for all. Insights for the week is what Father God tells me to receive from Him what He wants to say for the coming week, the week that is yet to come. He will prophesy and speak into it. What I receive from Him, I will mention it, and then we are able to pray together and align ourselves with the Word until rapture is the Lord. So this is ongoing until rapture in Jesus' name. Amen. And then, for whoever wants to acknowledge Jesus with water baptism, you can talk to me, and then we can make arrangements for you, because it is a time where you would publicly announce to make your faith known that you want to follow Jesus Christ. If you have repented from your sins and be willing to turn to Jesus, only then you can be saved. You cannot be just praying a prayer of salvation and be saved. No. You must repent and turn from your sins and then accept Jesus to come into your life, not just as Savior, but as the Lord of your life. Then you are truly saved. As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Remember, before we see you next time, plead the blood of Jesus over the doorposts and the doorframes of your heart, for the angel of destruction has to pass over. You are kept safe within. Declare Psalm 91 into your atmosphere. The Lord will put asunder all His enemies. In Jesus' name. God bless. See you next time.